Okay. So I need a way to contain this water. So I'm going to come in over here and I'm going to put in another rock wall using our Van Dyke Brown. Small row. Now I'm going to come down at an angle with this. Lush it in there, work it on in. A pretty good amount of brown right there. Come up just a little bit more. I like that. Buffer knife. Black, some white, touch of blue, gray it down a little bit. Cut off a roll of paint. Yeah, this is where I just like putting snow on a mountain. Just gonna kind of grab it, flow in. Like that. Got a ring on my finger. There we go. There we go. That's more like it. I'll get some bushes and stuff on there. It'll be alright. I want to bring some over here. So I changed the angle of the painting in the camera so you can see a little better. Got some of the glare off there. Okay, so now we got our rocks here. I could just leave that like that and that rock would look flat, but if I put foam around on the rock now, it'll make the rock look like it's more involved in the painting. So again, corner of my brush. And this is my blender brush. It's very soft. It's very soft. And you can see how I'm loading that. Get my bristles all opened up with paint on them in there. see the difference. It almost looks like a keyhole now. Well, a keyhole a century ago. Just come in here and right over the top of this paint right here. Just put splashes. Cut them all up through here. Just go to town with the splashes. Here with the other side, we can just right on the outer edge, just kind of wind those up a little bit, mist it out. Just mist it out ever so softly. Do that, just loading the brush the same way I was before, come right back in on top of what we just misted it out and put fresh little foamy splashes right over the top. So it's just, yeah, really plays off the mist really well. Grassy areas right in here. Humidity is going to be so high, there's going to be grassy things wanting to just soak up all that water as much as it can. Okay, so I said we wanted this to be like a little bit of a cliff face down to this area. Drop down in here. So I'm gonna grab some of that Van Dyke Brown and Dark Sienna. Just a touch of the burnt umber, or burnt sienna, burnt umber. Make this a chocolatey brown. Add a little black. This paint is very oily. Unfortunately, this paint is very oily. That's probably part of the problem I'm having. This is a cheaper paint. Not the Blick paint, but the traditional oils are very thin anyways. Bob Ross stuff is the better stuff to use. So I'm just gonna make a little cliff face through here with this brown. Just gonna bring it in. Not very thick. I frontwards. So, like on this side, right through there. Always good to be able to change your mind in the middle of things. Straight down, straight down, straight down, straight down. Straight down, straight down, straight down. I don't know how far it's gonna go down. In color right now. Make sure. Just kind of. I don't want it to be bright at all. I don't want to be bright on this. I want to be bright on this one. I'm going to hide any of the bushes.